Surely you've seen a science fiction movie or read the book at least once. And robots are often mentioned in such movies and books. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks to Amazon, this is no longer science fiction. It's a piece of life. And in 2019, Amazon founder Jeff Bezos predicted that within a decade, robotic systems will be advanced enough to grasp items with the dexterity of a human hand. 3 years later, Amazon looks to be making progress towards that goal. And so Jeff Bezos is leading another revolution. Well, by the way, you might wonder, what is the capacity of those robots? What can they do? What's the difference from humans? Can they replace humans, or will they replace them in the future? Let's explain briefly. Robots can pick things up, put them down, move them around, and more. So if you want to know more about Amazon Warehouse, here's the inside Amazon Warehouse, a place full of robots. Let's first look at what Amazon did to reach these levels. 2012, Amazon made a big investment to improve productivity in the supply chain by acquiring a robotics company called Kiva. Back then, the company had some automation in our fulfillment centers, but the Kiva acquisition was a big bet in forecasting the role innovation would play in helping Amazon meet their customers' needs while making work safer, simpler, and more productive for employees. It was a bold move, and it transformed their business. And 10 years on, Amazon has more than 520,000 robotic drive units that have added over 1 million jobs worldwide. And the company have more than a dozen other types of robotic systems in their facilities around the world, including sort centers and air hubs. From the early days of the Kiva acquisition, our vision is never tied to a binary decision of people or technology. Instead, it was about people and technology working safely and harmoniously together to deliver for their customers. And we can clearly see that. That vision remains today. And this vision continues to evolve. Here's another robot, Proteus. Proteus is Amazon's first fully autonomous mobile robot. Historically, it's been difficult to safely incorporate robotics in the same physical space as people. Proteus autonomously moves through in the facilities using advanced safety, perception, and navigation technology developed by Amazon. Like human, huh? And the robot was built to be automatically directed to perform its work and move around employees. This magnificent robot can operate in a manner that augments simple, safe interactions between technology and people. However, Amazon, of course, does not have two types of robots. Here is the third type of robot available at the Amazon warehouse, Cardinal. In June, Amazon announced a prototype of a robotic system called Cardinal that lifts and sorts already packaged orders, and the company claims reduces the risk of employees' injuries by handling tasks that require lifting and turning of large or heavy packages or complicated packaging in a confined space. The company says it expects to introduce the system into an unspecified number of fulfillment centers in 2023. And lastly, the company unveiled another robot arm that is called Robin, which handles a similar task with lighter packages. Van Chow, the company spokesperson, declined to provide details on the deployment of either the Cardinal or Robin robots. You see how much time Amazon spends on robots, right? Well, of course, Amazon only spends time on robots. The company also spends a lot of money. Amazon on Thursday launched a $1 billion fund to invest in companies developing supply chain, logistics, and fulfillment technologies. The first round of investments will focus on technologies that can speed up deliveries and improve the safety of workers in its warehouses. But you might ask, does this not reduce the human need in warehouses? Although it may seem so, the reality is not so. A lead at Amazon's robotics division explicitly told Forbes that replacing people with machines is just a fallacy that could lead to a company going out of business. However, robots could play a role in setting a pace of work that humans struggle to safely keep up with, something we've already seen happen at the company with automated management systems. In fact, from a logical point of view, some products are really difficult for people to transport and are dangerous for human health. For its part, Amazon claims all its new robots could actually help improve safety. And thus, this is one of the reasons why Amazon developed robots. So what do you think about this, guys? Does Amazon really care about employees' health, or is it purely for economic reasons that invest in robots? Specify in the comments. And that's it for today, guys. If you enjoyed the video or you learned something new about the Amazon warehouse, hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, and that bell icon for notifications. Peace and love, everybody, and we'll see you in the next video.